tell you that if it is in his time zone, he would really like to talk here. So I'll see when attend the session if it is on. I'll see if it is online and just try to connect him. Yeah.
Yeah.
Are
you
feel
angry in the?
Yes. I'll just see if it is on. So today's agenda is basically about RSI and we discuss rail routes, moving averages on RSI, the acceleration factor. Most of you, I think, have not heard about it. The divergence and use the divergence in the right way. That is more important. The reversals, what RSI is famous for, small one signal. This is the right way to use the divergence. Actually, Dn and I and Andrew have only found this way where divergence works. And all other way, I think, is not found. But like, more than profit, we suffered loss in trading divergence. There is an Andrew's personal RSI, we call it the CFG. I'll give you just a brief about it and we'll discuss the current market scenario. So RSI is the most popular classic public indicator, I must say, because the public uses it in a different way, in a wrong way. So we are going to just change the way today, at least these 10 people. And Andrew Carter defined this conventional usage of RSI. He refined the usages from oversold to overbought, and the works of Pony Brown and John Hayden implicates the work of Andrew Carter. John Hayden has worked on RSI, even Pony Brown has worked on RSI. Both are half work. The knowledge is half. So that's why I use the word replicate, and Andrew told me to insert this line in the presentation. So I did. So the first myth about RSI is RSI generally top out somewhere around 70 levels. At this point we want to start thinking of getting short or at least exiting our long trade. So basically when RSI moves above 70, we are thinking that the market is overbought and we think that we should at least short or get out of the long trade. The same thing in the reverse, when RSI bottoms out at 30, we think that the market is oversold. And we think that we should at least get out of the market or short. This is a myth. That's why I've written a myth about RSI. So we think that RSI at 70 is overbought. Now this is a chart where I have put this upper line is the 70 line and this lower line is the 30 line. I'm not concerned about that. Whenever RSI have touched the 70 line, prices have made higher bottoms. So really overbought means more people are buying, to put it in that. This is a daily chart, another example. Wherever RSI has touched the 70 line on the top, the market or the price have made a higher bottom. We are in an uptrend when the RSI touches 70.